Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are taking a look at the DLSS update for Stranger of Paradise, Final Fantasy Origin. So finally today we got, well today or yesterday actually, we got an update which brings DLSS to the game. And I am actually very impressed. The image quality on display with DLSS is insane. So today I'm going to be analyzing what DLSS brings to the table. And I'm going to go first over still images and then over temporal stability or image movement. And I think you're going to be very surprised by what we're going to be seeing today. So all the testing has been done on an RTX 3060 at 1440p resolution. Alright, so we're going to take a look at all different upscaling versions in this game. So here we have the native image, then we have DLSS in quality, balanced and performance, and finally FSR at 70%, 60% and 50%. So 70% FSR is comparable to quality, DLSS balance is comparable to 60% and performance to 50%. Now, one thing which I noticed is the faces in this game are very sensitive to resolution changes. And if we take a look at the native image, you can see the face very clearly here. And you can still see the face perfectly well, just as the native image, in all DLSS presets, even the lowest DLSS performance mode. If you take a look at FSR, however, even the highest FSR presets starts to destroy the detail on her face. You know, it's starting to go away. And the lower you go in the resolution, the worse it gets. So FSR 50%, the face is gone. Now, one thing which is very important is DLSS is very capable of reconstructing detail in clothing and very fine detail, especially geometry or very fine folds in clothing. So for example, if we take a look at her belt, you can see there is supposed to be some white color around the borders of the belt, and those white borders are sharper in the DLSS version. All DLSS versions have sharper border in the belt, but more impressively is that geometric detail in the buckle. You can see there is some sort of Z or 2 or something written here, and you know that is still present in all DLSS versions. You know, even the performance mode is a bit blurry compared to the quality and the native images, but you can still see there is some geometric detail here. There's supposed to be some 2, some Z, or something. Now, the FSR versions, you know, here, that detail is just gone because you don't know, you can no longer tell what it is. And the belt also has no white border anymore. The lower you go, the worse it gets. You know, the belt buckle here just becomes a circle, basically. So FSR performance so far is very impressive. Now, if we take a look at Jack here, his armor in the native version, you can see it has this band right here on the chest, and there is one fold right here. So this fold in DLSS, all DLSS versions, is not only sharper, but it is also that border is reconstructed much better. You can see a lot more detail around the border of that piece of his armor, even in the performance version. So there is a lot more detail right here. But more impressively are the folds around his armor. For example, his collar right here, you can see the crease in his armor is much sharper in the DLSS version. And even if you go to DLSS performance mode, that part is still sharp. You can still see that detail right there. That is absolutely insane. Even Performance DLSS is reconstructing this level of detail. Now, FSR, however, you know, with FSR, you start to lose those fine details, you know, that detail is just lost. And in the armor as well, there is no reconstruction done here. Now, this character, Sophia, if we take a look at the native image, you can see her eyes, the gaze. It's a little hard to tell where she is looking at, but the eyes are much sharper in all DLSS versions. It is much easier to tell where her gaze is going, the direction of her gaze. And that is not the case if you try to use FSR. You know, if you use FSR, the, you know, the eyes just stop. You cannot tell where she's looking at anymore. Now, the most impressive thing is that mask. So the mask, even in the native image, you can see there is barely any detail in the creases of the mask, but it is perfectly here on all DLSS versions, even Performance DLSS. So it is, even Performance DLSS is bringing out some really fine geometric detail, which even the native image cannot reproduce. And, you know, again, FSR cannot do it. It's just gone, you know? Speaking of faraway detail, how about we take a look at some rocks, you know? So this distant wall right here, well, in the native image, you can see, you're supposed to see the detail in the rocks right here of this wall. And if we take a look at DLSS, you can see that all that detail in the rocks is perfectly there. Nothing is lost. And it is all perfectly represented. Every single crease is still there. And even when you go to lower DLSS presets, all that detail is still there. So you're not losing any geometric detail from far away, even if you turn on DLSS to performance mode. Now, the same cannot be said for FSR, right? You know, FSR at 70%, the highest FSR, even compared to DLSS at performance mode, you can see that all that detail in the rock texture is just gone. You know, you cannot see it anymore. Finally, let's take a look at this tower over here, this faraway tower. So in the native image, you can see it's a bit hard to tell that there are two windows supposed to be in this tower, two blue windows. But in all DLSS versions, those two windows are sharper. You can clearly see there's supposed to be two blue windows right there. So it is very capable of reconstructing this very small detail. I'm talking, what is it, like 1, 2, 3, 4, this is like 6 pixels, man. This is 6 pixel data detail being reconstructed perfectly by DLSS, which is insane. Even performance mode can do it, but, you know, FSR cannot do it, of course. You know, if that detail isn't there, it's just going to be lost. So, you know, DLSS, even in performance mode, is reconstructing such a huge level of detail. It is just insane to me, you know? So this is how these three upscaling techs stack up. DLSS is extremely impressive. Even performance DLSS is bringing you higher image quality compared to the native image. And, you know, performance-wise, it's even better, you know. Turn on DLSS to performance, you're flying at 91 FPS. It is very smooth with DLSS in performance mode, and the game looks better. That is, you know, you can get higher FPS gains with FSR, but, you know, the game would have to look like the way it does with FSR, which is like that, you know. So please do not use FSR. FSR is very poor in this game. DLSS is very impressive, you know, take your pick. I would personally advise you to just take DLSS performance mode, because you're not losing anything, you know? detail is just better with DLSS. Even in performance mode, you get a lot more detail compared to the native image. Finally, the last thing I want to take a look at is DLSS in motion. So we're going to take a look at that in just a minute. Now, one big problem that the game used to have in the normal presentation is this shimmering problem you can see in the distance, especially in the buildings. This seems to be some sort of artifact from the anti-alias used in the game, and it is very notorious even in the console versions of the game. So if we enable FSR at 70% resolution scale, the problem gets even worse. So this is why I cannot recommend you to use FSR. It is very bad. It makes this problem very obvious and very bad. And we can actually take a look here and just compare how bad the problem gets. So on the left you have the original image, and you can already see there is some instability in the image. And when you turn on FSR at 70% resolution scale, the problem gets even worse. The shimmering is there. Now, the interesting thing is that if you turn on DLSS, you actually do not have this problem. The shimmering is almost completely eliminated, so motion is finally smooth. Even we go upstairs, you can see a little shimmering in the stairs, but there is not a lot of it present. And you know, it's very impressive because even performance DLSS can get rid of that shimmering. So if we compare it to the original image, you know, even the performance version of DLSS is more stable in motion than what the original image was giving us. So I think this is a very impressive demonstration of the technology you can have. And then, of course, if you use the DLSS quality mode, then the image is even better. Like I showed in the comparisons, you know, DLSS quality brings out basically all details perfectly. It looks very nice and it reduces the shimmering even more, but even performance DLSS is good in my opinion. Now, the game has a bug where if you set it to anything but 60 FPS and use DLSS, that clear motion is gone. So this is 30 FPS with DLSS quality, and you can see that the image is no longer stable in motion. The shimmering is not only back, but it is even worse than what it used to be, even without DLSS. Now, the problem is if you set the FPS to 120 and use DLSS, you also have this problem. So DLSS quality mode at 120 FPS, you can see that the image still has some shimmering, which was not present in a DLSS at 60 FPS. So we can actually compare. If you take a look at the DLSS at 60 FPS on the right, you can see that the image is perfectly stable. There is no shimmering in motion, and you know, they are both the same preset, so I don't know what's happening here. I think it is some bug with the game. So my recommendation for everyone is very simple. So first, my recommendation is that you lock the frame rate to 60 FPS and then enable the DLSS preset of your preference, either quality, balanced, or performance. Even the performance version of DLSS will give you more detail than the original presentation, and I would personally recommend that you set it to performance, because the game has some really intense moments where you can lose a lot of frame rate suddenly. So just set it to DLSS performance and enjoy the game. So that's going to be it for this video. I am very happy with the implementation of DLSS, and I hope we get to see this technology in more games, because getting better image quality and better performance is honestly really good. So even, you know, a 3060 can deliver this type of fidelity. This is very nice. And of course the game runs even better than on consoles at the moment. So yes, that's going to be it. Lastly, I want to thank everyone for watching. This video took a long time to edit and prepare, so please, if you like it, share it, give me a like, and try to subscribe to my channel. So that's all. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.